Hi and welcome back to another Mixed Media Tuesday, and today I'm going to make a really colorful and very fun mini art journal. I did keep the theme of my book the same, so throughout all the pages I used the cute girl stamps by All & Create. In this tutorial today we are going to make together all these pages. You will see lots and lots of different and fun techniques for mixed media, and I did use the ring binding system so that I can add even more pages in the future. So for my mini art journal, I thought it would be fun to use the same style of stamps on all the pages, and I went with these adorable mini stamps by All & Create. It features this lovely girl with the flower eye, which I find super cute, and it comes with so many different designs. There is a girl reading books, another who is crafting, there is a girl going shopping, another in the garden, lots and lots of designs. In my Mixed Media Tuesdays, I like to play with products from companies that have beautiful designs, perfect for mixed media, and All & Create is one of them. But you can definitely use these little girls for your card making as well. This is just one of their collection. They have even more collections from different designers, something for every style, and I really recommend you to check them out. It is a UK company, but their products are available in the US, and you will find all the links that you need down below. And I'll start with how I made my mini art journal book. I did use a die by Waffle Flower that gives you those holes on the side. I went with the second largest of the sizes, and you can definitely use your paper trimmer to cut out different pieces in any size that you like and just punch out the holes on the side if you want. And I will leave a link down below to the punch as well. For my discs today, I'm going with these plastic ones by Waffle Flower. They come in different colors, and I like the fact that they are quite small, which are perfect for my mini art journal. The paper that I used for all the pages is thick watercolor paper, which is my go-to when I am creating mini art journals. It's either this paper or the mixed media paper by Ranger. Here I did fit 10 pages, and you see I have enough room to add even more pages if I want to. But for today's project I'm only going to create 7 of them. I had to stop at some point. Also keep in mind that this is not a project that I did in one sitting. I worked on these pages throughout the week, so it is about one page for every day. So for my background I'm going to use sprays, and I'm going to show you the difference between oxides and dilutions ones. These are all sprays, you can mix them up together if you want to, but the main difference is that the ones that are oxides are going to come out very dull and chalky finish, while the ones by dilutions are really vibrant and super colorful. So on one day I did nothing but just creating the background, so that's what I'm doing here. I'm playing with my sprays, adding color at the background, and I always play with just 2 sprays for every one of the pages. I will do so many different techniques on top of them, so you don't have to really start with lots of colors. And since I have my fingers inked, and I do have all the sprays and all the supplies out on my craft desk, I'm going to make more pages than I actually need, so that I can make more than one art journals, mini art journals. This way I will have some backgrounds ready to go for another project in the future. So here I use dilution sprays, and you can see how vibrant they are in comparison to the oxides. I did many pages using both mediums, but for today I'm going to go only with the pages that are nice and vibrant by using the dilutions. The other pages I did bind them together with rings for another mini art journal that I can use in the future. So today I'm going for a very bright and colorful project. While you are in the process of adding color on the pages, you can even let them dry and then turn them around and add color on the back if you like. I just like to work only on the front, but that's a personal preference. Just remember to mix colors that are next to the color wheel. This way you will know for sure that they are going to look nice at the end. If you don't know what to create and you have no inspiration, this is a great way to go. Just create backgrounds, add color, and then play with stencils and other techniques that I'm going to show you. At the end of the day, you will end up having a lovely mini journal, and you can work on the pages on another day. Here I'm working with stencils by All & Create, very versatile designs that you can use on pretty much every project. I'm going over the stencil with a baby wipe, and you can even spray if you want. This is going to lift some color, it's going to give that design in a kind of a ghost effect. I will repeat the same process on all the pages. I will rotate my stencils, however, so that I don't end up with the exact same design on all of the pages. However, I do want to keep the style of all the pages similar, so that the mini art journal at the end is going to look coherent. So in the first pages I used the stencil with the octagons, now I'm using the triangles, and you will see that the design is going to appear even more as the page dries. Here again I am repeating the same process, but this time instead of using water I'm just going with one of the sprays that I used for the background, and the stencil that I'm using is the one with the squares. If you notice, all the stencils that I'm using today have a similar pattern, however they have different shapes. And here I'm working on the last page, and this time with the circles. This is my favorite from all four of them. And now for the next technique, let's do some stamping. For that you must use a stamp that doesn't have a specific design that looks like a focal point. Stamps with text or different designs like the ones that I'm using here are perfect for that. I'm going to use two of them, and you will find the link to everything I'm using down below. Now this technique is easy to mass produce and repeat. You don't have to think anything, just go with your stamp and go around the pages. This time I'm working with black ink. This way I don't have to rotate through different types of inks. I just use black for all the pages. Especially when you are mass producing, this is really easy way to go. It is going to add some visual texture on the background. This is going to add some interest there, but make sure that you don't cover up completely everything with your stamp. Always try to keep things quite organic, and notice that I'm using the stamp with my fingers. I don't use a stamping block, and that's because I don't care to have the perfect impression. You will see that in a bit I'm going to switch to another stamp. This is going to have a similar style as the first one that I used, because I want to keep the general style pretty much the same. I want the pages to not look alike, however to have the same elements here and there. This way the whole project is going to be coherent. So I did repeat the same process for all the pages using those two background stamps. And let's move on to another technique. I usually like to add white splashes to introduce some light, some white on my background, but for this project I decided to go with white embossing. So in this case I'm going to use some text stamps again on the background, and I will use stamps from one set throughout all of the pages. A fun way to work with when you are creating multiple pages is to use a big acrylic block like I'm doing here, and stick on top in different corners your stamps that you want to work with. This way you can easily rotate designs and stamp on your pages. I'm using Versamark ink, and again I'm not going for the perfect impression. Or if you don't want to use an acrylic block, you can always go directly with your fingers. I repeated the same process on all the pages. I'm applying white embossing powder, and then I'm going to heat set all the pages at once. And of course there are many more techniques that you can do on top of backgrounds, but I think that they look absolutely stunning as they are. Bind them together with the rings and you have a mini art journal ready to go for another crafting session. This way you have ready-made backgrounds for another day. They are not big, they are small, so they are not overwhelming. And this way, if you spend just half an hour every day, you can put together pages with your favorite stamps and quotes. And let's start with the first page. You will see that I will repeat the same process for all the pages throughout the book. So I am using the same techniques, however I will change the focal points and the quotes. I'm using all the stamps that come in this mini set, and there are three bees as well as a sentiment and a girl. I'm going to stamp that with alcohol friendly black ink, and that's because I did plan to color all the images for today with my alcohol markers. However, you can stamp them on watercolor paper and use your watercolors to color your stamps. You can even go with your pencils if you like. Just use your favorite coloring medium and go for it. Here I am using my triblends. I like that you get three shades of the same color in the barrel, but I don't have a big collection of them, so sometimes I switch to my Altenew markers. There aren't matching dies available, so I'm using my good old scissors to fuzzy cut the images, and I'm going exactly where the black line is. You don't have to do that. If you want, you can leave a white border all around, which is going to make fuzzy cutting way easier. And I'm going to show you in the last three pages how they are going to look, so you have both options. When you do that fuzzy cutting exactly on the black line, you will never get it perfect. So my go-to technique here is to go all around the edges with a black marker. This is going to cover up any mistakes. In the stamp set there is a quote which I am going to use. It says, "Be beautiful." I did stamp that with Versamark ink on black cardstock, and I'm cutting it out so that I can create strips of the words. And since I have all the elements ready to go, it's just a matter of putting my animages together on top of my page. I'm using some washi tape, just a piece of it on one side. This is going to provide kind of a ground for my girl to stand on top. I also want to add a very tiny strip of black. It is so such a small element, but I think it really makes a difference. I'm going to stick that there. It is going to give more definition on the ground. And for sticking everything together, I'm using my tacky glue by Simon Says Stamp. I know that this video is quite long, but keep in mind that it didn't take me so long to create those pages. All I did was sit down one day to create the mini art journal with just the backgrounds, and then every day I just worked on one page, which was actually just stamping my images, coloring them, cutting them out and sticking them on top. It is a fun project to create. You can use any stamps that you have at home. But of course, to demonstrate for today, I went with All and Create and this flower girl. If you check them out, you will find that there are tons and tons of mini stamp sets like these ones that I'm working with today, with the flower girl in different positions doing different fun things. I always grab my gel pen to add some highlights. And I'm going to call this page done. Here are some close-up photos where you can see the details on the stamped images as well as on the background better. And let's move on to the next page. This time I will go with this adorable stamp set that gives you the girl with the books. Again, I did stamp everything. I did color them with my alcohol markers and fuzzy cut them. Here I was thinking that I wanted to give wings on my little girl, and I have this stamp set that has many different styles of wings that you can play with. I am going to stamp a couple of them, but you will see that I am not going to end up using them on this page. However, I'm going to use them on one of the other pages that I'm sharing today. And after cutting everything out, it's just a matter of putting everything together, sticking them down on my page. I am going to have the girl sitting on top of the stack of the books. Again, I did use a piece of washi tape on a couple of corners. This is going to add more interest, and at the same time it grounds my image, my focal point, in one way. I'm using the a quote that was included in the same stamp set, and I decided not to use the wings for now. When I have a white quote, I outline it with a black marker. When I have a black quote, then I outline it with my white gel pen. Again, I'm going over my images, my cutout images, and I will add some highlights here and there. This is such a fun project, and you can see your little art journal coming together day after day. And if you are going to buy just one of these mini stamp sets, then I would definitely recommend you to go with this one. She is crafting, and she has all kind of crafting supplies all around her. Now here I had enough space on my paper, so I went ahead and stamped one more stamp set. This way I had everything on paper, I could take it with me while watching TV and just color. When you do your coloring, one thing that you just have to keep in mind is to decide where on which background this girl is going to go. So this way you are going to use colors that are contrasting to the background, and it is going to help your focal point to stand out even more. So you see here I have a background that has oranges and pinks mainly, and I used aqua for her dress. Again, I'm using washi tape throughout all of my pages. If you find that your washi tape doesn't stick too well, always make sure that you add a little bit of glue underneath to make sure that it's going to stay put. And I'm going to stick down my girl and the two flowers. And I have to admit that it took me too long to cut out those two flowers. However, I'm going to show you in the next pages that leaving a white border, which makes your life easier, isn't that bad. It's going to look just fine, especially with a design like this one, which is cartoonish. So white border around it, which is going to give kind of a sticker look, is going to work just fine for these designs. Now, I also have this piece that says Joy, and I did stamp it with stamps that you will see me use in the next pages. I am going to stick that down, and notice that I did use washi tape, which is black mainly, with words throughout. The words say mainly inspiration, make, art, and things and words like that, which is a great washi tape, but I really don't like to use it as a whole. I like to cut out strips, and sometimes I even stick it upside down. It doesn't really matter. Here I finished off the page by sticking a sticker that says start doing things you love. Again, I outlined the quote with black marker. I did do my highlights with my white gel pen, and here are some close-up photos on this page. So here I am putting together another page, again using the exact same techniques, using washi tape here and there, so all the pages are consistent in terms of everything that I'm using. Then I'm going to stick on top the images that I colored and die cut. And all these images come from the same stamp set, except from the wings, and you did see when I stamped those, as well as the clouds that come from another stamp set than the girl. Just like always, you will find linked down below everything I'm using, and hopefully by seeing all these products in real action, you can easier choose what is best for you. So in this composition, I gave her wings and she can fly. I am going to add a few clouds so that it looks as if it is sky, and also notice that I went with purple, which is a contrasting color on top of the orange and yellow background. This project is great for a beginner. You don't have to think on how you can put things together, just stamp and stick, and the hard work is done by the design of the stamp as well as the colorful background. So in the next pages I'm going to fuzzy cut everything by leaving a white border all around so you can see the look. It doesn't look bad, it looks just fine, you don't even notice it. Plus it's going to help the elements pop against the background. Now for this girl I did stamp her eye one more time so that I can fuzzy cut it, and I'm going to stick it on top. This way I am going to end up having dimensional petals, just for a fun touch. I'm going to stick her down just like I did with the rest of the pages, and I'm going to stick her in a way so that I can have all the other crafty supplies going all around her. I'm going to give her some ground with washi tape again, always repeating the same steps and keeping everything consistent. The white border around the cutout images really help them, as you can see as I place them at the bottom to stand out, but this is not something that I would do if I was going for a vintage or grungy look. I would definitely cut out exactly where the black lines are. Lately, in my Mixed Media Tuesdays, I share many smaller projects like mini art journals or mini tag journals. Since I can share more projects, I can go through many techniques at once. And the feedback has just been amazing, probably because they are smaller in size and it is easier for beginners. I have also shared a few mixed media canvases, but I haven't used my art journal book for a long, long time, and I'm thinking that maybe for next week I will work on a double page spread in my art journal. Let me know what you think down below. So here you see me working on another page. This time I'm working with this girl who is shopping, and I so miss doing that. I can't even remember when I went to a shopping mall, since we are still on lockdown and shops are closed. So again here, notice how I colored her outfit. She's wearing aqua so that she can stand out against the background. You don't want to go with a dark orange or a dark pink, since she's going to blend with the background. In the stamp set, along with the girl and the shop, there is a quote that says "Stay chic," which I did stamp and cut out to stick it there, but I'm going to finish off the page by sticking this sticker down that says "Leave a little sparkle wherever you go." And again, here are some close-up photos on this page. If you notice, all my girls have brown hair. That's because I have brown hair and I tend to use my color of hair. But you can go really crazy. You can use any color and make them really funky. Okay, and I think this is the last page for today. I did color her dress with red, as you can see, so it stands out, as well as the pink flower against the background. A piece of washi tape to ground her down, just a touch of glue at the back to make sure that it's going to stay put there, and then glue everything on top. For my quote for this page, I went with the word bloom, and then I also went with "and rain will make the flowers grow," which are all included in the same stamp set as the little girl. The only thing not included that I'm using here are the clouds, which come from another stamp set. And to tell you the truth, this collection by All and Create has many stamps that you can use to build up different scenes with those girls. So you can find pets like cats and dogs, you can even find furniture to create little scenes inside the house. They are so much fun, and you can play along with all the different designs that they have perfect proportions so that they work together. I'm doodling some raindrops coming out from my clouds, since my quote talks about rain. And I'm going to call this page done and let's put the book together. Oh, by the way, this is the stamp set that I used the cloud from. And I'm planning to use this little girl on the yellow page. I have many backgrounds ready to go still that I haven't used. Here is a close-up flip-through of my mini art journal book. It really makes me happy, so colorful and so cute. You will find still photos at the end of this video, as well as on my blog if you want to see exactly how I put things together. You will find the link to my blog down below, as well as links to all the supplies that I used for today. And I still have plenty of space to add even more pages. So I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching today, for your lovely comments and the likes. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. And also make sure to hit the notification bell. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.